Welcome back. Now we've got more Resident Evil Desperate Escape. More of Jill. It's yummy. All that good stuff. Let's have a nice body in that suit, dude. Well, she has a nice body, and we're out of that suit. Okay. It's been a long time since I've made a ton of sexual comments about a female. Yeah, definitely about a female character, but about any character, because I find it very hard to believe I would make a sexual comment about a male character. I wouldn't put it past me. I'm just saying, I find it very hard to believe that I would be in a situation like that. But you never know. Maybe if I were to. Okay, so now we are lost. This is the area I ended up in after my lovely video recorder program shut off. The door I was looking for that we needed, but we needed to help. Deal with more rocket launchers, which of course are being controlled by... Wow. Actually, where are we? I could be wrong. I still don't know this area all that well. It's crazy! Crazy! Okay. Help me kill him? Fine. I didn't want the satisfaction of getting the final blow. Then I'd be using the sentence, the words blow and Jill in the same sentence. Yeah, it looks like I'm not gonna stop doing that, so. Sorry. I don't know where to go. Not looking good for our characters. Lost. Inside a little area. There's a locked door. Inside a little area. God. I bet you it's something really stupid. Hey, get off me! Nobody asked your opinion. Take my foot to your face! Bitch. Okay. Locked door. I bet you there's just a ladder somewhere that I just did not see. I bet you. I ran around here for like 30 minutes. Lost. Oh, look. There it is. Okay. Now that we're up here, this is the area I thought I might have been in before. We're not saying I think we're actually in the right area. I'm not sure. Could be a different one.
Okay.
Much like these enemies. Two different models. That's it. For all the advancements the gaming has made, and I mean, you look at this game, even now, being about 5 years old, it's still fairly good graphic-wise. But, man, they sure have not gotten to the point where they actually start adding variety. I really think that should be more of the next step in the game. And yes, we pass the ladder. Staircase. I know it now, didn't know it then. I mean, you look at a game like this, or Resident Evil 6, especially this, because it's, you know, so much older now. Still the second newest game that I've ever played. Okay, I got other stuff. But the graphics are good. I mean, great graphics don't necessarily make a good game. So do find Resident Evil 5 to be fairly strong. Ow! Jerk! It's not the Resident Evil I like, and it's not the direction I would like the series to go in, but still good. You know? Can't shit. 6 is kind of sad. 5, you know. But I really think they need to start, you know, working on more variation in enemies, so that we don't have just the same enemy over and over again. So I think it'd be kind of cool if that was where they put their focus rather than graphics. For the time. Because they've gotten to a point where the graphics are scary at how far and how good they are. So I really kind of feel like they should be doing more. Hey! Talking here! More effort into other things rather than just graphics. I think Grand Theft Auto games are a perfect example. I mean, obviously you can't make an infinite number of enemy or character models, but it would be nice if they had a lot more variety. Yeah, we gotta blow that up. Didn't know that at the time.
Come on!
Understood.
Yeah, like Grand Theft Auto where you know, so many pedestrians, people running around, it'd be nice if there were enough of a variety where it would be very rare that you would see the same character model in the same area. I think, and I don't know anything about game design, so I don't know how complicated that is. It may be an unnecessary effort, but I'm sure when the PS4 comes out, it'll be able to handle that. There's a thing, we gotta blow that up. Takes me a while, but we get there. I kinda feel like little things like that, maybe making backgrounds not quite so repetitive, I think would be some of the next things I would like to see in game. Of course, in the Resident Evil series, I'd like to see an auto-aim brought back. I mean, keep the manual aim too, because it gives you so many more options. Oh, look at this. An ammo bunker. I like ammo bunkers, especially when we can loot it. But I think it'd be nice to make the game more aesthetically pleasing if they did that, rather than like necessarily improve the graphics, because, like I said, these games are getting to the point they look fine now. A lot of them are starting to look the same. I don't know how many games look like these Resident Evil 5 and 6. I've seen bits and pieces of LPs, walkthroughs that look like this. So, graphically they're fine. I just like to see them start to add more variety. Like I said, for the Resident Evil series, I'd like them to bring some sort of an option for auto-aim back. Just to help the visually impaired gamer, because frankly almost forgot it. We got a shotgun now, we will be using that. Good stuff. But yeah, I'd like to see that brought back. I don't know, I'd be curious, anybody watching this, what would you like to see them bring to the next set of consoles? I know the PS4 is about to come out in a few months, which now I'm dating this LP, but that's okay, it's only 2 minutes. And it's already dated on. And we've already been there, as we've already been here. But we got it, and a shotgun, so it was worth it. That's kind of like where I would like to see the focus. I'm sure their focus will be just graphics, make it look as real as possible. I'm sure that's what they will be focusing on. Said, I don't know how much more they can do, and given that I think some of the stuff I was talking about would improve the game enough, a lot more than improving the graphics, or would improve gaming in general, rather. But I don't know. Feel free to offer up your suggestions for what would be a good thing for them to work on next-gen gaming consoles, which they won't do because they've already done whatever they're going to do. I would also add backwards compatibility. Yeah, we're going to stay here shooting for a while. Find some enemies. We're going to shoot at them with this. That bridge thing, where I know know we end up hitting it at some point, so we're just gonna kinda do that. I don't know exactly when I actually hit it, so I'm just kinda letting it play out. But we'll get there, see the last something out of the way, that way we can walk across, but then that might be another thing I wouldn't mind seeing. A couple of little ways of the characters more abilities. Like, they kind of did that, well, actually, they did do that in Resident Evil 6, and that was one thing I actually did really like about Resident Evil 6, was I liked the melee attack options. I thought those were done really well. Very happy with that. I hear Jake's game is very good at that, that his character does, like, awesome melee attack. I never played him because I played Leon's game, and that was the character I wanted to play as, because he's my favorite male Resident Evil character. So, at least, the main, well, I guess, between him and Chris, he would be my favorite. I guess Jake's kind of adding himself to the mix as far as playable male. So, we'll see if they bring him back. And I guess they have Billy, too, but they, it's been over 10 years since we've seen him. Resident Evil is. I don't know. I just think there are a lot of little things I'd like to see them work on. But they won't. And that's it. We're gonna just kind of keep blowing shit up. That's what I like to do. Look at that. So I know at some point I got that thing off of that bridge. We were good there. That bridge is actually the thing I was talking about. I had to look up because my vision, I did not see that there was an opening there. I just saw the little wood thing. I kind of wish they had actually given you like a full opening, but instead they have to have you maneuver around some little boards, and I did not see that that was actually open. That is the only thing I had to look up throughout this entire two video LP. This will definitely have the record for shortest LP of my career. Well, that's kind of cool. Got to get to play as Jill again. Yeah, we still got a lot to do, but we are getting very close to the end. But again, it's two videos. I mean, this, with all my editing, probably going to be just over an hour, so. Look at that! Magnum! I don't know why I bothered picking it up, because I never use it. Of course, if I had known what all I had coming up. And if you're playing this and needing help, I'll just tell you, there are no actual bosses. There are some tougher enemies that you would have seen in Resident Evil 5. I won't spoil them, because you'll see them. And a lot of it depends on the difficulty settings as well. Because I think in some difficulty settings, you get like the soldier of the Navy instead of the village one. I went amateur easy mode because that's how I do things. And if anybody watching this is wondering, I will be continuing on with Silent Hill 3. This was just kind of a shits and giggles. I want to try this thing. And spoiler alert, which you already probably know since I have it up, I happened to beat it on my first try, so granted, I died many times through. And I actually don't mind the lack of a save. Like, I was not happy. This right here, I didn't see the little opening. I was not happy when I found out that there was no save option. And it does take some time. It did take me several hours, so this isn't something I'm going to just be kind of running back and forth. We're about to the final. We got some enemies we're going to have to deal with in here, and then we'll be at the final thing we have to do. So we're full push. Yeah, this is pretty fun. I enjoyed this mini game. I say this and we're still going, but there's no end credit, so I kind of have to talk this up as we're going. I like this little mini. I like it better than the Ada one in Resident Evil 4. Although the Ada one definitely had its strong points as well. I like that it was longer and had save options. Really, that two incredibly difficult puzzles.
Finish it, but
that's, I can't knock the game just because I'm not good at it, so I think that was a good mini game as well. The separate ways. Alright, you can actually skip a lot of this. The fighting thing, you don't have to. There's a door, not that one. Oh, you bitch. You're gonna die. You're gonna die. But there's a door we gotta go to. And, oh god. Once you go in there and let Josh in, we'll come back to this door. And that's really all you gotta do. Again, first time play, I didn't know that. And I could have played this again, knowing what I know, but, you know, I'd already done it, recorded it, this and that, so, you know what? Hell with it. This is what we're going with. Yeah, this is a fun little... One thing Resident Evil 6 did not have, granted they had several campaigns, but... A mini game might have actually been more fun than the actual game. I mean, seriously, Resident Evil 6. When a zombie grabs you, that's a quick time event to get out of that. That's retarded. Just saying. When I bought that game, I wanted Resident Evil, not Heavy Rain. And I knew I wasn't going to get the classic Resident Evil that I really wanted, but I was expecting this, basically. Yeah, Resident Evil 4 and 5. That's what I was expecting. You know, they did do some nice... They made some nice additions to that, but then... I don't even know if you can call them quick time events. Because if it was just, oh, here's a scene, press X here, you're good. No, it was like weird ass, like Heavy Rain stuff, or interactive thing. I don't know, I didn't know. But we're not playing Resident Evil 6, we're playing Desperate Escape. Jill is much sexier than anybody you play as in that. Well, yeah. Ada is pretty nice as well. So, yeah, we're just gonna. There's a door around here somewhere. We're gonna find it, I promise. I'm still just kinda looking around. And yeah, I didn't do live commentary, but. That's because... Sure, I'm talking and looking at items, and you're being like that. You know what? I was gonna let you go. No, this is personal. Personal! Bitch. Die. So yeah, one little... But yeah, I had to edit so much, and my reactions would not have been worth putting in here, so. They weren't bad. I actually didn't get frustrated, except for when I couldn't figure out where to go, so. Went back. Relatively easy, easy mode at least, anyway. Relatively easy little minigame, so. It'll be fun. We got one more major thing we gotta do.
I owe you one.
Jerk. Stand still so I can kill you. There.
Pick it up.
Josh, you better. You just like beating women, don't you? That's what it is. You're a woman beater. I hope you're not married, because I'm sure that you'd be a wife beater. We don't need no domestic violence here in Resident Evil.
Pick it up.
Okay.
Jerks.
You take it.
Understood.
We actually need to run back to that door. Yeah.
Damn it! The bridge is out!
Doug, come in! The bridge is out! I'm going to need you to come to us!
There's a landing pad on the roof of the communication facility. Can you meet us there?
Anything for you, Miss Valentine. I'll be waiting with open arms.
He's quite a character.
That's one way of putting it.
Yeah, I could have been running right there and should have been running for the door right there, but whatever. Now we'll run for the door. And somebody left us a nice little box with more stuff.
You take it.
Understood.
Josh stuff. I gave him the rifle, hoping that he would shoot at some of those rocket launchers.
Here it is. Give me a hand.
Okay. I set it to broadcast on the same frequency as Chris's PDA.
Please be there, Chris.
Jill, are you all right?
I'm fine. Don't worry about me. Just listen carefully. There's something I need to tell you. Wesker's superhuman strength, it comes from a virus. But the virus is unstable. In order to maintain a balance, he must inject himself regularly with a serum.
So if he cut the supply of serum, he loses his strength.
Affirmative. But he just took a dose, so it's gonna be a while before he needs another one.
Damn.
Listen, Excella said that the amount administered has to be precise.
So if he injects too much, it should act like a poison. I think she used a serum labeled PG-678W. PG-678W.
I'm gonna try to find a way to escape. You need to find that serum. Excella always kept it with her, in an attaché case.
Jill. Come
in. Chris. Chris?
It's no good. It's being jammed.
It's okay. I told him what he needed to know.
Hurry. Doug should be on the roof by now.
All right.
All right. Now we got some item collecting to do. And then we'll have the last thing we have to do. Like I said, no bosses, just regular enemies. A few special regular enemies. I think in those regenerator, whatever those things are, from the factory show up.
You have my gratitude.
Versions of them, however, I pick easy mode, so they're not there. Reapers, I think is what they're called, actually. And I said, it's, you know, we're it's been a good, like, 9 months since I played this game, so I don't know. Yeah, some inventory stuff there. I cut most of that, but I missed that one, so my bad. In the interest of time, I would like to have cut that, but, you know, you can't catch everything.
Pick it up.
That's good.
When you're hooking up, you definitely don't want it. The herpes and the syphilis, AIDS, the gonorrhea, they're not good. You don't want any of them. I should know. No. I don't have any of that. Okay. My goal here was to item hunt without triggering the next cutscene. However, we do pick up stuff. I really wish we had more health items and that I had more health, though. That's really what makes this last part challenging for me, is we have one health item, which Josh has to use on me. And every time I tried it, I would get hit. He'd have to use it on me right away, and it's just not good. So that is one thing. Really could have used more of his health items, however, in the end, it ends up being okay. Like, they really give you enough stuff in this mini game, unlike the regular game. Not about It explodes. Oh, you power. You bitch. Why you gotta be like that? Yeah, this timer is just how long it's gonna take for the helicopter to get to. So how long we've gotta hold out in this area of empty. Not that bad. That kind of sucks. Okay, why? Cutscene. Dodge those bullets. Dodge those bullets. Always remember that. Somebody shooting at you, be sure to dodge. I think I've ended up wanting to use my flash grenades. I took some of his flash grenades trying to save some space, and I kind of want to use some of them just to. God man, Jill is a tough person. I mean, she gets shot, she gets right back up, and just keeps shooting. Of course, she's a video game character. Oh, still, I, you know. I tell you, Jill's a badass. I want to make a Jill tribute video, actually, for a song that I have. By a 80s sounding rock band, although they're a 2000s band, called Reckless Love. They have a song that I will do a tribute video to Jill about. Revelations is coming out. I'm gonna wait. But fortunately, having LPs of her run of Resident Evil 1,
thanks.
Resident Evil 3, and now this, I'll already have a ton of videos to choose
from. Take these!
And thanks! Then, if I ever succeed at Revelation, I'll have even more stuff to choose.
You have my gratitude.
It's all gonna look out of place, especially showing some PS1 stuff in there. At least the version of Resident Evil 1 I did was a remake. So that helps down the chain. There comes the chain. Now comes the party. I think we get two chainsaw guys and two of the I don't want to imagine how difficult this thing is to do apart from what enemies that they're gonna take on. I don't want to.
I'll be there as soon as I can. Just hold out a bit longer for me, Miss Valentine.
And my phone. Which is the shit I have to do, but I. Won't take that much longer. Die! Hey phone, I got you. I know! God damn! Trying to do commentary! Fuck! Okay. Got one chainsaw guy down. I'm pretty sure there's a second. And we're gonna have another Gatling gunner. Just gotta hold out. A little bit longer. I like this area actually. Like there are a few areas that they can come to, but I don't feel like they can surround you quite as much here. Like they kind of start coming through over here now, but like for the longest time they wouldn't come through from like behind right here. So I like this area. Oh god. I don't think I've gone into dying status in a while. Oh, God.
Oh, for fuck's sake, I got BOWs flying all over the place. I have to make a detour.
We got more time to wait. More time! And more inventorying stuff I should have cut. God damn it! Yeah, I want to use these flash grenades. That would maybe I can find some health, but. This part would have been nice to have some health. I don't. There probably is some health in here somewhere. They would have to give you health in here somewhere, and I just didn't find it. Inside that building right by, I see a bunch of stuff. Dude, fuck me. Get away. Get away. I don't like you. See what I mean? There's the other chainsaw guy. There's going to be one more of the Gatling. Yeah. Isn't that bad? I like the spot right here. I feel like I'm more in control over where the enemies are gonna come from. Here, rather than me. Hey. Another one of those. But like I said, there's no boss, so as long as you... Like, I would save your shotgun ammo for this part, if you can. You don't really... God. Oh my god, I'm stressed. Wow. Wow, okay, shoot. Shoot! Shoot, Jill, shoot! Shoot! But there's no boss, so if you can save up your shotgun for this part, your shotgun is going to be very useful. In fact, your shotgun is probably essential here. I really should have used more grenades here. I like the guns better. I don't like sitting there trying to fumble with controls while the battle's going on. If you're good at this stuff, then...
Come on! I have visual contact in your position. You sure know how to throw a welcome party. Prepare for extraction!
And then we're gonna get a pretty badass ending cutscene. Alright, we got this. But that's not bad. Just some enemies. I was stressed because, as you can see, I'm near death. But, you know. God, come on, save me. Save me. I called you Jake, but. I need the shotgun. Now, if you got ammo left in it, shotgun is your friend. Fuck. Die.
He was a brave soldier.
He was my friend. And if we don't help Chev and Chris, he will have died for nothing.
You're right. Let's go see if we can help them.
And now the question remains, do they make it in time to save them? Well, You'll have to find that out in Resident Evil 5. Fortunately, my Resident Evil 5 walkthrough is already on my channel and in a playlist, so by all means, check it out. Yeah. It's really long, that's what she said, but it's up. So, with all my LPs, how I end them? Victory sip. Well, yeah, this was pretty cool. This was fun. And I don't get a lot of time to really do a lot of post-commentary, and that's okay. If you have any game suggestions, feel free to send them to me. I'd love to hear them. I always love bringing these videos to my channel. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see y'all with whatever I do next.